Hello guys and welcome to my next guide. This is my monk guide. Probably most of you guys already know this guide as my wizard guide. It's kind of popular, but I made some variations of it and one huge variation, to be honest, to this one which most of these people are using. And I wanna just introduce it to you so you can farm a little bit some higher creator rifts with the monk. So let's go through the skills. First of all, as you may already know, but if not, I'll just do it. Like if you didn't knew it. Sorry for my bad English. Way of the Hundred Fists. Way of the Hundred Fists is a attack with a lot of attack speed. You know, you can see it. We are attacking a lot of. A lot, and well, its name, it's Way of the Hundred Fists, so we are Hundred Fists, blah. It's not a Hundred Fists, obviously, but the attack speed is pretty nice. We are doing a lot of attacks, and with the Holy Rune, the way, the Fist of Fury, it's called, we are getting a buff, or actually a debuff to the mobs, and they take an additional 60% weapon damage as holy over 3 seconds. So that's pretty nice, and why we are using this is we are having a lot of life on hit on my gear. I have life hit almost 30k and I'm using a specific gem, but I'll talk about that later on. So second skill, I'm using Dashing Strike with Way of the Falling Star, and this is a very important spell because you really need to get out of shit fast, and that's working with this spell very well. You can see I just dashed through two screens away. So yeah, it's very important to position yourself because it really depends sometimes from the burst damage you want to avoid it. For example, molten explosions, or if you see a thunderstorm or some other shitty stuff of the elite pack. All right, next thing, I'm using Sweeping with Inner Storm. There are two things why I'm using this. First of all, it costs a lot of spirit, so I can spam that with my mantra to proc the Zumvoku set, which is the main part of this build, but I'll talk about that later on as well. And this rune is holy, so I'm using a holy spec actually, and I'm getting 8 spirit per second, which is important too to spam or to get the decoy of the Sun Wukong set. Alright, next skill, I'm using Serenity, and that is a variation of the kind of popular build with the Breath of Heaven and I think the Blazing Wrath rune. I think the Serenity is just so much more com it feels just so much more comfortable because you can just stand in this sh every shit packs for 4 seconds at least, and you don't have to worry about your health and something. I mean, you can probably survive most of the shitty things without Serenity as well, but it's just so much safer with that, and due to the fact that you have a lot of cooldown reduction also on your gear, or you should have at least, you can spam it a lot. I mean, I don't have it permanently up, that's would be OP, but I think I'm almost having it like a 6 second cooldown, so I can use it still very often, and that's kind of important because in some packs you can't just to manage to survive with the life on hit only, so the Serenity is definitely safer. Then another spell I'm using is the Epiphany Inside Rune, which is very important for this build because otherwise you won't have that much spirit regeneration, and with that you can spam everything kinda just however you want. You know, I just spend all my spirit in like 1 second, but with this spell, and I'm keep auto attacking, yeah, I can kinda spam more, you can see it, and the decoy is spawning kinda often as well, and if you attack you can spam a lot, like really a lot. You can see it, or you will see it at the end of the video, in my second part of this guide, where I'm recording a gameplay video. And Mantra of Healing is pretty nice as well, because, well, first of all, If you activate it, you will get the decoy of the Sunwoku set first of all, and a nice shield, because and due to the fact that you are spamming it like almost every time, you are having it up like kind of 24/7. I mean, the mobs will break it immediately, but still, the extra health actually will help you a lot. And the last rune is pretty nice as well, because if you fall below 50% life, which is happening kind of often as a melee class, you will take 30% less damage, and that's very important. I mean, some of you may say, "Hey, why aren't you using Mantra of Conviction? You're dealing more damage, or why aren't you doing that? It's increasing your toughness with, I don't know, maybe movement speed." Well, you can do that, but in my opinion, this is like the best mantra rune for you. Like, it's at the top. Alright, the passives are kinda easy. Beacon of Aether, you need a lot of cooldown reduction, as I already said, and that's giving you 20%, and yeah, that's a lot. And I'm also using Sash the Initiative, and you're having this buff like almost constantly up, because you're attacking a lot of mobs, and most of them will be above 75%. I mean, you focus not only one mob all the time, you just want to spam like everywhere, you know? Just not focus on one target, and you're hitting probably more targets anyways because of the AoE effect at the end. And yeah, so you're having this buff kind of often, and you are getting 30% attack speed, and attack speed is a very important part in this build as well, because you have a lot, you have 30k life on hit, and it's like life leech on pre-Reaper of Souls release. It's not that OP, but you can see in the video later on that I'm kinda healing myself a lot with this life on hit. The next passive I'm using is the non-physical damage taken is reduced by 25%, which is pretty needable, because it's kinda sucks to be honest, because they changed one with everything to only 40% of the elemental resistance from items will increase your resistance. So you need more non-physical damage toughness, so that's a passive you want to use in higher crater rifts. You can choose between that and Alacrity if you're running lower crater rifts between 20 and 30, you can use Alacrity, but above 30 you should definitely use Sixth Sense. Alright, let's go over the gear. First of all, you need the Sunwoku set for sure, because the Sunwoku set says that you're getting a 20% damage increase buff when you're using a combat staff, and I'm using the Flying Dragon, which is definitely the best weapon so far for this build. Yeah, but I'll go to that later on. And yeah, so you're getting a 20% damage buff from that, and your four set bonus is very important, because that's your main damage. And because it says if you're spending 75%, not percent, just 75 spirit, you're getting a decoy which will release a explosion of 3,500% weapon damage. And I'll just demonstrate how the how it looks like. There it is again, and blah, you know. And it spawns often, and I'm doing like I think 150 million crits with it, so that's pretty nice. Okay, I'll talk about the specific Sunwoku parts now. You want to get these following stats on your Sunwoku parts. First of all, on the shoulders, dexterity, vitality, all resistance, and cooldown reduction. Why the cooldown reduction? Well, it's obvious, you want to have epiphany and serenity up as much as possible, so cooldown reduction is very important. All resistance, dexterity, and vitality should be clear. I mean, toughness, yeah, that's easy. And on the gloves, you want the tri-factor ones with dexterity. You could get, or some people are using attack speed, cooldown reduction instead of attack speed, but in my opinion, attack speed is greater than cooldown reduction because of that gem. No, fuck. That gem, because if you have it above rank 25, or Yeah, you gain 1% cooldown reduction per stack of swiftness, and you're having 15 stacks, so the maximum stacks, all the time with this build, because you attack so much. You know, every attack of this animation is probably like 77% a swiftness buff, so you're having it up at the maximum almost every time. And I would have then 55% cooldown reduction. And yeah, I'm doing kinda well with this. Okay, the helm I'm using as well. Crit chance, dexterity, vitality, and the socket for cooldown reduction and the other stuff should be clear as well. You don't have any skill damage on the helm which you wanna use, so yeah, just get a vitality, the toughness, which is important. Yeah, some of you may say, hey, the Sunwoku amulet would be better so you can use Lyric's crown. That is true, but the thing is, I got a really shitty Sunwoku amulet, and I'm currently using another amulet because, yeah, the stats are just better, and I'm getting more damage with this and more legendary games, which you wanna definitely use as well, three of them, but I'll go to that later on as well. So yeah, you wanna use the crown. But if you have a nice amulet, well, like socket, crit chance, crit damage, and maybe you can choose between reduced cooldown of all skills and holy skills. You don't need the main stat. You have like almost 8k above of for sure. So the socket is greater than the main stat. Okay, the following set I'm also using is the Auk heals. One on the chest and the bracers. On the bracers, you want to get more holy skills. I only have 15%. This kind of sucks, but the main stat was kind of high, so I used them. And the secondaries are pretty bad as well, I see. But never mind, they are fine for now. You want to get crit chance, holy skills, dexterity, and vitality on it. Yeah, like as much as you can get of them. In this case, I'm using dexterity, vitality, life percent, and 3 sockets, but this one is I'm not I don't like this. I prefer this one, but I can't didn't get the reduced elite damage yet. You know, I don't have any red crystals anymore, so need to farm a little bit more for them. I just used like 2k on the on this chest, not on this, on this one, and I didn't get it. So it's really rare if you are having one with the stats, dexterity, vitality, reduced damage from elites, and 3 sockets, and the single resistance on the secondary stats. It's very, very good, and you're definitely lucky with this one. Yeah. Okay, I'm also using the Witching Hour. This is just the best build you can get for damage. So yeah, nothing to say about that. I'm also using the Depth Diggers. The primary skills that generate resource deal 99% additional damage. So my Way of the 100 Fists are getting buffed a lot by this one, and yeah, I really really like this change of the Depth Diggers. I definitely useful in this build. I'm also using Ice Climbers because I couldn't get another set in this build. So yeah, Ice Climbers, I felt like the 10% reduced damage from cold attacks might be useful, and well, to gain immunity to freeze and immobilize effects is not that important due to the fact that you are using Epiphany so often. But still, it's nice to have if you are getting stunned or frozen in Crater Rifts at the higher ranks. You're dead for sure. You can't do anything. I mean, you can of course use Serenity and Epiphany, so that should be no problem for you. But still, there's some time where it's just shitty, and you wanna get this stat for sure. I mean, I don't know. If I think about it now, you can also use some other things like Blackthorns maybe for the Witching Hour and the Ice Climbers. But I prefer the Witching Hour because it's increasing your damage so much with the attacks with and the crit damage. Okay. Now the Flying Dragon is a nice, very very nice stuff. I am using this socket item. I don't know the name anymore. It has a weird name. Gift of Blah. And yeah, you wanna get as much Damage roll as possible, obviously. The 10% damage is very important as well. The dexterity is nice, and I got the life on hit on it as well. You can choose between life on hit and vitality, but I definitely would recommend to get the life on it on other parts than if you are not having it on the Daibo. So yeah. Okay, let's talk about the rings and the jewelry in general. I'm using Unity for solo play, I have to say that. If not, I'm using this holy Stone of Jordan, but I would prefer one with without dexterity and 6 crit chance on it. So you have holy skill, 6 crit chance, increased damage against elites, and a socket. And the gem I'm using in this ring is the Mirina Pla. I don't know the name. Fuck it. It's just a 50% chance on hit to smite a nearby enemy for 3,000 weapon damage, and that is very, very awesome because the 50% chance on hit is like almost 3 times in a second, and you are feeling this 3K damage. And yeah, if you have it on rank 25 and above, you definitely smite one every 5 seconds. Well, that's kind of shitty. I mean, it procs very, very often. You just need to look on it in my next video where I'm showing you the gameplay of Crater Rift 35, where I'm making the rank 23, which I'm currently at. I think, yeah, 23 on the solo monk. It's kind of nice. I can get more. Did got some shitty spawns on Crater Rift level 36. I made it, but not in time. So yeah. But that was off topic. Obviously, you want to get it as high as possible because the weapon damage is getting increased. I mean, yeah, it's a nice one if you get it more than 25, but well, I would focus on another game, and that's this one. Simplicity's Strength. It's increasing the damage of your primary skills by 41%. And that's like the Depth Diggers. So I'm getting a 140% of the primary skills. That's pretty nice. And yeah, I'm feeling this damage very well, the increase of it. So if you're leveling this one and that one up above 25, it should be nice. I mean, it's only ranked 32 now, but it's working. I'm working on it. So yeah, and this game is also very OP because of the second stat. Primary skills heal you for 2% of your maximum health on hit. I'm currently having, as I already said, 30k life on hit, but the thing is, if you really want to concentrate on the green numbers in my next gameplay video, you will see that I'm healing myself for 100k most of the time. So I'm getting 2% of it. It's kind of weird. I mean, 2% is not 70k, but for some reason I'm healing a lot more with this gem, and it's very important as well. I think these two games are like a must-have. You definitely want them at rank 25 because this game is, well, also already said, getting you a lot of attack speed, which is just so good in this build, and the cooldown reduction as well. This is just the best game for this build you could have. By the way, I think I already mentioned the stats on the amulet, so you want to get on the Ring of Royal Corendor like these stats: dexterity, attack speed, crit chance, and a socket. I got a kinda bad one, but still, you can improve it like to 6 crit chance and 7 attack speed and 500 dex, obviously, but it's definitely very good as well as it is right now. So yeah, that is like the basics of this guide. I think that was it. Yeah, you will use the Stone of Jordan in group play, as I already said. Yeah, I think that was it, and I will hopefully see you in the gameplay video as well to show you what you are capable of with this build. Thanks guys for watching, and see you in the next video.